I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I am focusing to the Hartnell governor problems. Okay, this is a list of the formulas I have kept aside. This is the initial compression is nothing but delta 1 divided by S1 by K. Effective governor is nothing but effort. The governor effort is nothing but S2 minus S1 divided by 2. Governing power is equal to effort into lift. These are the formulas which is arrived from the derivation. Okay, now this is the problem. Each ball of the governor has a mass. Mass they have given it. The mass is nothing but 1.5 kg attached to the one arm and the bell crank lever. Okay, the lever is here. The other arm of the bell crank lever lift the sleeve against the force exerted by the spring under the compression, which surrounded the governor spindle. The length of the ball and the sleeve, length of the ball they have given. B is given here and A is given. A is equal to 125. A is equal to 125 mm. It should be converted in terms of meter, 0.125 meter. And B is nothing but 75 mm. 75 in terms of meter, it should be 0.075 meter. Every time the A should be greater than B. Okay, this is the important part. A should be greater than B. Next, the fulcrum is 90 mm from the for the maximum and minimum. Okay, maximum they are given it. Fulcrum is 90 for the maximum. Fulcrum is 90 degree from the axis, okay. And maximum minimum radius are, okay, they are given r, small r, they are given 90 mm, that is 0.09 meter. And r1 they are given it, r1 is 75 mm. 75 is nothing but 0.075 meter. And r2 is 115 mm, that is 0.115 meter. Next, the sleeve being lift, the lift of 300 mm, okay, the sleeve being begin to lift at speed of 300 rpm. Therefore, N1 is given as 300 rpm. Begin to lift, N1 they are given it. N1, and the maximum speed is 6%. N2 is equal to 6% is nothing but you have to do in this way, 300 plus 6 divided by 100 into 300. You will get 318 rpm. This is the procedure you have to follow in percentage if it is given in percentage. 6%. Find the rate of the spring, that is K you have to find out. And the stiffness of the spring, stiffness and the equilibrium speed. That means you have to find out N at radius of 90 mm. You have to find out N. Equilibrium speed you have to find out. N we have to find out. Okay. Now diagram I will just write roughly here. This is the diagram they are given it. Sorry, this is the lever. This is W plus S divided by 2. This is the diagram. This is the axis of the governor. These are the balls. I'm showing it. This is F2, this is F, this is F1, this is the radius R1, this is mean radius R, this is maximum radius R2, this is A, sorry, this is B, sorry, this is A and this is B. For this one, it goes here, W plus S1 divided by 2, for maximum, it moves up to W plus S2 divided by 2. We have to find out the stiffness as well as the average speed or equilibrium speed. Now, just I will substitute the value of K here. What is the stiffness value? K is equal to, what is the formula for K? Stiffness, formula for stiffness is here. Now, formula for stiffness, the formula for stiffness is written here. 2 into A by B whole square. F2 minus F1 divided by R2 minus R1. Here the comparison is carried out between this and this. If the comparison is carried out between this and this, you have to write F2 minus F, R2 minus R you have to write. Now here the comparison is carried out between maximum to minimum. Therefore, the formula will be in this way. If it is in this way, instead of F1, you have to write, this is F, normal F. Instead of F1, you have to write F. Instead of R, you have to write R, normal R. Instead of R1, you have to write R here. Okay. If it is carried out between this and this, then you have to write F minus F1, R minus R1. You have to write in this way for finding the stiffness of the spring. Now, this is the formula. I will follow this formula. With the help of this formula, I will find out the stiffness. Now, A is known, B is known, F2 we don't know, F1 we don't know, R2 is known, R1 is known. R2 is known, R1 is known. Now, just I have to find out F1 and F2. Now, what is formula for F1? F1 is nothing but what? F1 is nothing but M omega 1 square R1. Omega is nothing but 2 pi N1 divided by 60 whole square into R1. Therefore, what is M? M is nothing but 1.5 into 2 pi 300 divided by 60 whole square. R1 is 0.075. Therefore, F1 will be 111.03 Newton. Therefore, fine. I will follow the F2. F2 is equal to M omega 1 square omega 2 square into R2 M 2 pi N2 60 whole square R2, where M is nothing but 1.5 into 2 pi into 3 N2 is nothing but 318 divided by 60 whole square into R2. R2 is 0.115. The answer for this one is 1.29 Newton. We got F1 and F2. Already R2 and R1 is known. Substitute here in the stiffness. You will get stiffness here. K is equal to 2. A is nothing but 0.125 divided by 0.075 whole square. F2 is nothing but 191.29 minus 111.03 divided by R2. R2 is 0.115 minus 0.075. If you calculate, the answer will be 11147.73 Newton meter. The answer will be, this is the Newton meter. Okay. Now, what I have to find out? I have to find out N value. This is the N. Now, how to find out N? The formula for this one is F is equal to M omega square R. That means M 2 pi N divided by 60 whole square R. We know that R is known, 0.09, but we don't know M. Before this one, we required F. How to find out F? There is a derived formula we call it a F. The name of this one is we call it as a instinct. At any instinct, CF. This is the formula we have arrived in the derivation. You have to use this one. I will use this one in order to find the F value. F value. I will use this formula. This formula doesn't change. It is fixed one. Whatever the R value, whatever the maximum to minimum or minimum to maximum, if any combination is there, you have to use the same formula. F is equal to F1 plus F2 minus F1 into R minus R1 divided by R2 minus R1. Fn is known. F1 is 111.03 plus F2 191.29 minus 111.03. R is nothing but 0.09 minus 0.075 divided by 0.115 minus 0.075. The answer for this one is 127 Newton. Once you get the F value, substitute in this formula, you will obtain the answer. Now, F is known, 11141.127 is equal to M is nothing but 1.5 2 pi into N divided by 60 whole square into R is nothing but 0.09. If you solve, the N value will be 308.75 RPM. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.